G'day guys, Calvin, Catching Company in New Zealand. I've defected to across the ditch and I'm wiring a Haltech on a 1UZ. Now I'm still in my workshop, but Haltech's an Australian product and it actually makes sense for guys in Australia to use an Australian product. It makes sense for New Zealanders to use the New Zealand product, though I don't mind sending links to Australia either or anywhere else in the world, because any of these ECUs, the same principles apply. In this case, Haltech 2500 was chosen because I want transmission control. But more on that later. This one, I'm going to wire up the coils. Real simple. I got the plugs. I got the wires. I've got a big earth. And that's going to be grounded onto the cylinder head. On the corner of that cylinder head. Guys would like to think that I remember these pinouts perfectly every time, but I don't. I cheat, I've got a coil, and it's got them written on it. So pin one is my 12 volt supply from my ignition relay. Pin two is the feedback loop. We're not running the feedback. I run that in standard ones. Though I could be tricky and wire it into the Haltech in this case, but I'm not sure it would actually be of any benefit unless I could specifically see the signal. And then the earth, the ground, is in pin 4. Snap the lock in, onto the next one. Now on this particular job, I've chosen to use these coils. Come on. So this is a V6 Hilux coil, same as the 1NZ V6. They bolt in on 6 of the holes anyway. They bolt into the factory UZ hole. On a Gen 2, they do fit down the sleeves, down the spark plug holes. On a Gen 1, they do not. That's why this one was sanded. I've done a video on that, and I didn't actually realize when I did that video, well, the one on the coils, on coil on plug options, that there was different size holes in these engines. But I've since done a video on the size of your hole. And then once we've got all the coils into the, all the plugs on the coils, of course, I do have the other side to do, but I can probably get away and do that later on. We then, it's time to feed them into the ECU. If you're running an ECU with 4 drives, then you need to group your coils. In this case, because I'm running a 2500, I've got 8 drives, so I can use all of them. I've already gone through and allocated the colors and matched all the colors up, which makes it much easier. In the B plug is ignition 7 and 8. And so in the A plug is the first 6 AVI. So starting at pin 3, we go through and we pop our wires in. If you are using a pre-made loom, which is probably easier if you haven't done this sort of job before, buying an unterminated loom or a fly loom, flying leads, is probably going to be the easiest way for you to get all the wires that you need, and it's actually already into the ECU. Because I'm using much smaller wire, I'm using Tefsil, we make from scratch and we just buy a plug kit, plug and pin kit. One big trick is reading the instructions. That's really important. Understanding what you're doing before you start doing it. I took this information and I wrote it in a form that I understood. And that allowed me to work through and check that I had everything allocated before I started wiring. And that means we get a better job at the other end because of the planning we did at the beginning. That's very, very important. So that's ignition done. Of course, the power supply to the coils is from the ignition relay through a fuse. Very, very simple. If you're running different coils, of course, wire them appropriately. If you've got coils that don't have igniters, then you'll need to put an igniter in the system. That's ignition for now. We'll talk to you again soon. Catch you later.